And now back to Brazil with Kyley.
Recession, a phrase powerful enough to bring tears to the eyes of even the most hardened bankers and corporate types. As you'll probably know, unless you live under a rock, we're currently undergoing a global recession. Recession is where the GDP per capita falls for two consecutive quarters. Most of you are probably thinking, how has the recession affected Brazil? I thought things only sucked for me. If you believe this, then you're proof that Blair's education policy has failed miserably. This recession is global, due to the fact that most nations' economies rely on other countries. On the line now we have Zain al-Latif, who for legal reasons can't be shown. Which is quite lucky because she's ugly. So Zaina, I hear there's a problem with the credit market. How has this affected the economy?
It was a very disappointing performance, and I think the reason for that was the sudden stop of the credit market abroad. And in Brazil, there is one particular segment, which is the auto, which is very dependent on credit. And before the crisis, the sales of vehicles were booming, two-digit growth, and suddenly we had a shrinkage of credit, and then that's why the country was very impacted.
So how do you expect things to go in the near future?
Yeah, I'm on the optimistic side of economy, so I'm expecting positive growth.
And what do you think for the sustainability of Brazil's economy?
What we see is that consumption remains very resilient, I mean household consumption, so we are about to reach pre-crisis levels. When we see, for example, retail sales, they are currently at pre-crisis levels. The bank lending to household as well. And of course, what is still lagging is investment. So what we can say so far that investments, they bottomed during the first half. To see a positive trend, to see a rebound, I think we will need some months to see that. But we are expecting a huge acceleration of investment during the second half.
Thank you, Zaina. And now a few words from our sponsors.
Fim de ano na Globo, com mega star Michael Jackson, a sua noite de Natal vai ser show. Hoje, depois de Por Amor, ele vem arrepiando. Michael Jackson, especial. Quem tem Globo, tem tudo.
Brazilians, especially thieves, rely heavily on mugs like us visiting the area. 5.2 million people visited Brazil in 2008, bringing $5.8 billion of income. Yes, I'm talking about tourism. The industry provides jobs for 1 in 11 Brazilians and accounts for 3% of the country's GDP. Brazil is popular for its amazing natural beauty and for its exotic cultural experiences, from the depths of the Amazon rainforest to the carnivals of Rio. This makes it very popular with ecotourists. And it's not just foreigners, there's also a great love of domestic tourism in Brazil. The domestic tourism industry is even more integral to the Brazilians than the international one. Last year it brought in $21.8 billion. Hello, and welcome to Brazilians with Kyley. We can't call it Brazilians with Kyley.
Brazil with Kyley.
We haven't got anything to heat the wax.
Say let's piss in each other's mouths.
On the line now we have, what's the name?
Zain al-Latif.
Zain al-Latif. Good?
You're good.
On three.
Just do it.
There was a reduction of imports and government policies on trade tariffs.
Don't throw stones at our
pre-pussy.
Oh, yes!
Dr. Jeremy.
Yes, speak up, boy.
What's your name? Where did you come from?
Dr. Sir Jeremy Hewitt. I'm the leading historian on all things to do with Alagoas, a state in northeast Brazil, far away from Sao Paulo.
My late father lived in a white old age. Stop laughing. Well, I was on a roll there. That could have been...
You don't even like...
No, I can't. Look what they're doing.
It's at Mexico.
Now all you're good for is... fuck.
You're on camera. Smile.
Don't worry, this is like a really long outtake.
That was Legion, who will also be doing a presentation later. I hope you look forward to seeing
it. Okay, my arm.
Its economy isn't as powerful.
Come on, while the creepy man's walking in the background. Man.
It's
or old woman. Put on woman.
Now, we're in Alagurs. I say far away from the bright lights of Sao Paulo. So, Dr. Jeremy Jackson Jim. There. Now, new question.
I've got a hard one.
It's all Kyley. You've got a hard one.
So, Rory, tell us, where exactly?
Rory? I live on a ship and my dad's from Franca.
Okay, shush! We're recording. This is what happens when the star doesn't get his cup of coffee. You ride the field with him like a horse to get from destination to destination. Or just, you know, for the hell of it. It's even better when you anyway,
this is geography work, I promise you.
Best bets. Let's say Moulin Rouge in France. Damn good beds there, and the people in them, yeah.
The domestic tourism industry is in fact even more integral to Brazil than the international one. As last year, it brought in about... You can't actually tell me to move left if you're not actually moving the right seat.
I'm saying.
Yes, why can't you just go?
Hello, we're here with the only white ginger Brazilian in the world.
Like, you know, move this way. Just go move fucking left.
The boom fell. The entire geography. Look at this.
Thank you.
Sao Paulo is a state on the
domestic tourism industry is even more integral.
Great benefits come from transnational corporations.
Benefits? Oh, come on.
Benefits have great God, you massive ginger killer!
It was fine! That's underwear.
Script. Yo.
Yeah, just say that. Wasn't say that.
I'm not going to wait outtake.
Yep.
Okay.
My script is perfect.
No, it's not.
Shut up.
My
arms are.
No, it's not.
Do you mind?
Now go.
We're still rolling.
Come on. Can't work in these conditions. Look at that. Bastards, get rid of that fucking sun.